Hey everyone, just a quick reminder before the video starts, the giveaway is still going on through parts 1 through 5. You can enter in every video. All you gotta do is like, comment, and make sure you are subscribed. And it's gonna go and do for me in this little pre-do, because I forgot to mention it. But now that I mentioned it, enjoy the actual video. Blah! Hello everybody, welcome back to another video. Today, we are back in Conan Exiled, and as you can see, He-Man here. The red-headed He-Man with some eyeliner. My dude is so ugly. We got some stuff in store. As you can tell, the base has seen some improvements. We're almost taller. My ultimate goal is to get taller than that, than our sacrificial altar here. That's gonna be pretty cool. And, as you can see, our level right now, is that someone running? That is someone running. Okay. As you can see, our level right now, we are level 7 point something. It took me like an hour to level up from grinding. I think your best bet of leveling up is from killing things. And I don't know, killing things just seems very iffy right now. But yeah, the grind, very, very real. So I'm gonna give you a tour of the house real quick. We'll go in through the front door to show you guys how everything's gonna be. I'm missing a couple doors as a quick heads up, just because, doors cost a lot of twine. I don't like spending twine. So here we have our humble abode up to a second story with a nice little expansion, little peepee thing up there. And a really nice corner here for the shrine. I really like how we incorporated that, actually. But then we're going to head into the sandstone window. And as you guys can see in here, we got the entirety of the basement to us with nothing but part of the shrine to give us warmth and comfort. Then I actually invested in a couple technologies here and the recipes. We got the armorer. Ooh la la, we got the armorer. And we also invested in stairs, so we're still saving up some points. We still got to hit 8, 9, and 10 before we can get the Thrall Taker, which is seriously what I want by far the most. But and other things, probably some better armors, and ultimately maybe even the Stone Dagger. That seems like it might be better than this crappy little sword. Yeah, blunt, brittle sword. We could definitely get some better stuff going, but that's besides the point. Maybe that light chest piece too. Anyways, what I want to do today, I want to get that armorer's bench going. That's a big goal to at least see how that goes, because that's something brand new. And go back out for another try. We got way more arrows this time. So I think we could go and take on a pretty sizable camp and get some pretty sizable XP and play things out from there. But like I was saying, before we do that, I do want to hunt a couple animals to get the hide we need. And also here we got this little room. We got an opening here right by the shrine. There's actually a little easy way to jump in there. Oh, a little bit of lag. Easy way to jump in there. All I gotta do is plop down a door so people don't meander on in. Same with the door on the top. But for real, the bow, I'm a really big fan. It seems to be really strong. So I'm definitely a fan. But to get to the armorer's bench, 240 stone, 160 wood. Neither of those two are gonna be too hard to get. The problem that we're going to have getting is that hide. So we got to go around. We got to meander our way somewhere. And we got to pick a fight. Now, me, I'm a pacifist, right? And if you knew me, it's probably not true. But let's assume I'm a pacifist. You know, my character. He-Man. The redhead. That's what we're calling him. Alright, no Popeye in this series, comrade. Very sorry. Who knows? Maybe comrade make, or maybe Popeye make a return. Is that a cave? Yo-ho-ho! Alright, well, might be a slight detour here. I am interested in... Also, I see it. This isn't server lag, by the way. I've been lagging really bad out of nowhere. I started getting like 300 ping. I was even in TeamSpeak, and, dude, it was just not working. So hopefully, this isn't too bad. But hopefully, there's a lot of these guys over here, actually. Yeah, we're getting a good amount of hide. Oh, there we go. We actually got 50. Okay, before we head on down, then... That's a cave. And these things are definitely protecting it. I think there's some cool stuff in store. Oh, and the turtle respawn. I have not seen these things for a while. You guys don't understand. But I did want to show you guys something really cool. Who dat? Who dat? I don't know who that is. I don't want them to bug me. I'm scared. I'm a wee little boy. Who is that man? Someone well armored. I'll let him do his thing. In the meantime, though... Very cool thing. Oh, we took the eggs. I was going to show you guys a really cool survival tip for when you start yourselves and potentially start trying to survive on your own in Conan Exiles. There's this very cool thing, these nests. You can get eggs from them. They have a maximum of 3 eggs, I think, what those eggs do. I built in a really good spot right by a couple of the nests. These eggs are so good. Look at this, right? I got 18 hunger, 84 hydration, all that jazz. 7 shellback eggs. We'll use one. Hunger goes up by like 11, and hydration goes up by 5. This stuff is amazing. Those eggs are like your best friend, and then the... Oh, I thought I clicked on the insects. The insects, on the other hand, they get you like one at a time. You can... I mean, if you have a ton from gathering a ton, it makes sense. You know, it's an easy little spam use, and boom, shakalaka. We're back up to a lot. But now that we got the hide, we do need to begin stockpiling in the ways of stone and wood. It's not going to be too bad if we just find a couple rocks. Problem is, we have a lot of weight on us from these branches, mainly. These branches, I don't know what it is, dude. The branches are really heavy, and I'm not ready to do that. Next time I level up, I might go up some points in encumbrance. We have a lot more plant fiber than I remember. Okay. We're going to go ahead and craft a lot of twine. Twine is so useful, but we need 240 stone, 160 wood. Again, this shouldn't take too long. We're going to craft Armorer's Bench. Hopefully craft up some better armor from that. We got someone here. Hello. Is that a person? Hello? Who that? Uh-huh. Oh, what up, Drax? Oh, thank God. He's not going to murder me. Yeah, I'm lagging right now. Pretty bad ping, so I don't know. Oh, yeah. I can hear you now, though. That's better.
It's like freezing jittering.
Yeah, I've been having that too. How you doing? I'm just over here grinding for XP because it's ridiculous to level up.
Good, man. I've died. I have no idea where my body is, so I'm trying to get you again.
All right. Good luck with that. Best of luck. May Conan be with you. Alright, like I said though, we're just gonna go over here, hit a couple of these, hopefully the weight- Hello! Okay, we TP'd somewhere. Just hit up a couple of these, it shouldn't be too bad. Like I said, if you're playing on a Blitz server, you get so much stone compared to what you normally would. We need 240 of this stuff. I'm just worried that we might get over-encumbered before we finish this. If that's the case, we'll probably drop off. As weird as this sounds, we'll drop off our stuff in our fireplace. It is literally our chest right now, our fireplace. I really should invest in a real one. But alas, I'm a lazy sack of crap. Still so excited for that cave. I have no clue what that could even contain. And, dude, caves, they got some good stuff. I was listening to some friend. Damn it! We're like one short from 262. Damn. What is weighing us down so much? I actually have no clue. Twine? That can't be that heavy. Maybe all of this stuff. How much are arrows? A lot. Okay. Well, our encumbrance is at 100%. I say, let's eat the rest of these eggs. Maybe that'll bring us right under. Yeah, no. Seeds are a lot. Putrid meat. Let's drop the meat. All right, we got back down to 98. Let's drop this stuff off. We'll get the wood. We'll get an armorer's bench. I'm thinking we'll put it in the basement. I think that might be a okay spot. Now, once we get to the thrall taking kit, that's when I think we're going to start investing in some more advanced stuff being put outside, like the Wheel of Pain. I'm not putting that inside. Hate to break it to you. Listen, I don't want blood on my beautiful wood floors, okay? Not happening. But we just need one more stone. And then, what was it, like 160 wood here? Yeah, that's probably gonna be like a couple trees. No biggie. Okay, never mind. That tree was a wuss. That tree had like no wood. But yeah, every hit's pretty much an average of 10. I think we can get 3 to 4 hits per tree. So give me about, not even, 20 seconds. Start the timer, baby. Okay, these trees have to stop freaking asexually reproducing. It's kind of scary. All right, I'll like break them and then they just split off into two. Like rabbits. God damn. Okay, and I think 1 or 2 more trees. We're slowly getting more putrid meat too, just from negligence. But boom shakalaka. We got the 160, we got the two. It was 160 and 260. It was actually 240. Oh, all right. We'll pick it up out of here. And we'll begin work on what will be our greatest build yet. Start hyping this up, boys. Start hyping this up. And as a reminder, totally kind of forgot, I'm carrying too much and cannot move. Of course I am. Can I not move? Oh, I can move more. It's just that stupid notification pops up. Reminder, if I didn't remind you guys yet in the video, I hope that isn't something about to attack me. Yeah, reminder, if I didn't remind you guys yet, hopefully I remember to post edit that. Make sure that you guys do like, comment, and make sure you are subscribed to be entered in the giveaway. Going up until part 5, you can enter in every part 1 through 5. Winners should be announced in part 6 if all goes well. But, yeah, let's get this armorer's bench going. We kind of can't move till the damn thing gets crafted. And let's get some fancy, dancy stuff going. I'm really hoping it'll fit in our basement. I don't know how big this is. If it's too big, I might be a kind soul, maybe put it outside. I don't think anyone here is too big a dick, you know? Yeah, look at that. Look at how much weight we just saved. Problem is, oh, Josh FTL. I saw, dude. I think I hear him being attacked by something. What's going on out there? Oh, dude, you can murder that thing. They're easy. Alright, I got you, bud. Yeah, see? I'm a helpful man. There you go. I'm a helpful disciple of Set. You good. You good.
Cheers! I won't eat you when the whatever god that I chose comes.
Alright, yeah, I like that. Peace treaty. You know, some peace between the gods. This is a good world. Diplomacy. World War 3. Let's make it happen. I mean, not make it happen.
I like your logic.
Alright, so Josh FTL, he owes us big. But I don't care what he owes us. We got overlapping with another object or terrain. What's the damn thing overlapping with? I don't think we can put it on here. We might have to put it on a roof, maybe? Can I see even? We might be able to do it on roof. Yeah, okay, so I guess technically speaking, it's not big enough or something like that. If I could see a little bit, guys, trust me, I can barely see. The moon's at about midnight right now. Thank God that nights are really quick. I can barely see a thing. I'm about to walk off the edge. It doesn't help that we have this weird thing going everywhere, but we should be able to push this over to the floor there. And, oh, there we go. Is that where it should be? Yeah, it's kind of off. Whatever, though. We got the armorer's bench. Let's check this thing out. We can make the wooden targe. Oh, we need 16 wood. Look at that. It's like a sign from the gods. We had 16 wood. Why don't we create this thing? And, that thing's reinforced with iron. We don't even have iron. Like, that's how magical we are. And we can also assign thralls to these. I don't know what that does yet. Don't worry, though. We will figure that out very soon. I am very keen on becoming the king of thralls. Okay, I want everyone being a servant to me. Yes. Yes, I think daytime should be coming up soon too. Yeah, moon's setting. Sun should be rising. And things will be looking a-okay. Is this thing done yet? It's about to be. I'm really hyped for this. And then when we get level 8, we'll probably invest in some better weapons. Hello, wooden targe. Low grade. Not that great, but still. It's better than a big old nothing. A lot better than that, actually. And you know what else we can do with this? I can drop a bunch of stuff off here that I don't want to have on me. There we go. Beautiful. Especially that twine. I don't want to risk losing that. Bones are pretty good, too. And we have so many branches. It's very windy, apparently. But here we are. We become stronger. We definitely kind of messed up the placement of that. But let's equip this thing. Let's see how we look. Dude, how are we looking? No, I think we got to V, right, to look around. There we go. Only partially naked, but hell yeah. We are looking bona fide badassery. How do I hit V again? There we go. How about if we do it with the back to us? How do we look now? Okay, kind of scarier. Can you see? I don't know if you can see, you know, my junk in the trunk. I don't know how the nudity works on this server. Look at that beautiful armorer's bench, though. Ooh, can I just, like, chill on this? Oh, yeah. You guys know I'm about to get the best thumbnail in the world. Now, what's C do? Oh, that unequips everything. Okay, interesting. Control makes us crouch. So we have to hold control. Okay. There we go. And voila. There we have it. The workbench. Ooh, looking fancy. Actually, I'm going to go ahead. Let's disable that. And there we have it. A little workbench. Good look at it. it'll look at everything about it, and we'll get to work with it. So let's undo that. Undo that. Anyways, we got a cave to adventure into. We're gonna make waste no time doing that. I want to check this damn thing out. I want to see what's up. We got bows and arrows. We got weapons. We got everything. You know what we should do, though? Properly figure this stuff out. Zach, check this out. Our sleeping roll here. We put it down a while ago. It should still be here somewhere. I have no clue where the hell we put that thing down. Oh, there we go. Fiber bedroll. We actually have to claim it first. We got to interact with it. And now we update our spawn point. See, last time I didn't do that, so as a heads up to everyone, if you're planning at all, make sure. This isn't like other survival games where you plop it down and you're done. You actually do need to kind of, quote-unquote, sleep in it first, if that makes sense. I don't know if it does. Encumbrance-wise, we're looking really lightweight. We're almost halfway to level 8. I don't know what this dude's doing. He's fighting a thrall over there. Who is this? I'm actually curious. Who is that? Josh FTL. Oh, what up, Josh? What up?
Hello.
Oh, hello. That thing's being laggy as hell. Okay. Like I was saying, though. I want to see what the hell's down in here. This has caught my attention. And, oh, ho, ho. It has every reason to catch it. Okay. So it might be dark in here. Oh, yeah, it's looking very dark. I'm hearing noises, too. What the hell? Woo! That scared the crap out of me. A, he's an ugly piece of crap. B, he came up behind me. What the hell? Oh, C, he also sounds like an abomination. Oh, wait. He is an abomination. God damn. Scare the crap out of me more, dude. I will harvest you, though. I'm gaining corruption. Oh, crap. I forgot about that. The more time you spend in these evil caves, the more corruption you get. We do need to watch out for that. Yeah, these caves, they're not a safe place. And as we gain corruption, we do lose some valuable things. Okay, so let's get back to our sword here and begin exploring. And we got some sorts of crystals. What the hell? Where are we? Oh, we got lots of those things. Lots of them. Okay, okay. Huh, huh. I will fend him off. Huh, huh. Ow. He hurts. There we go. They're pretty easy to kill. That's the good news. They're not hard at all. Die. Okay. See, I gotta keep an eye on my health and stuff, though, because as we gain corruption, we lose max health and stamina. You can see that. We're going down in it. So we want to spend minimum time possible in these caves. I'm not going to bother looting those guys. Those are low tier, you know? Nothing interesting. Can we harvest these crystals, by the way? Is that a thing? No? Damn, can't harvest them. Thought we could. Let's head back to that sword, though. The hell else is down here? I want to find whatever's the end of this cave. This thing. Oh, die! Die! Ugh. See, I don't know how we get rid of corruption either. That's something we're gonna have to figure out. I think doing religious acts might help cure us a little bit. Just make sure not to spend too much. Yo, what? Did you guys see that? Hold on. First, can we go up there? Do we have to go underwater? I think we do. All right. Underwater we go, I suppose. Dude. This is crazy. What is this place? There's a giant arena here too? Holograms? They're worshiping the monkey? Do I need to worship the monkey? Hello, monkey.
O Lord of the darkness, of men who are not men.
I'm gaining corruption.
Give us strength and suffering in equal measure. Let our bodies be pleasing to you, and our minds quieted from this conscious thought. Let us find the inner rages and loose them upon the earth. We give our sacrifice into your hands. Appease your thirst in the slickness of blood. Grant us the power of your might, the eternal strength of Hanuman.
What the hell? I'd love to keep looking at this, but we can't spend much more time here. So let me just get a quick selfie with this thing in its hands, because that's going to look amazing. Still, though, what in the hell? I don't know about this. We gotta go, though. This is not our place. This is not... We're just becoming more and more corrupt. There's nothing else for us here. I don't think there is. I don't want to spend more time to keep looking around, because closer we are to that monster. Can I steal his eyes, maybe? His eyes look valuable. No, there's sunlight, too. That's creepy. Let's get the hell out of Dodge, man. Dodge gets shittier every time I visit it. If you guys have been watching, you guys probably know that. If you guys continue up with any other series I do, man, Dodge, getting the hell out of Dodge, signifies getting the hell out of a place that just gets shittier every freaking time. Now, I don't know why we're gaining so much corruption. I don't know how to get rid of it. And that really sucks, because we just lost a lot of our max health to this corruption crap. See, what I... Because he said he wanted... let's block. See how that looks. There we go. There we go. He can't do... Ow. Okay, he attacked a little. He broke it already? Dude, I barely even had a chance to use the damn thing. Bastard. Alright, I'm gonna keep harvesting you, though. We didn't get much XP from these guys. Maybe the turtle guys, if we hunt those a little bit more, we'll get something. But that cave. That's creepy stuff, man. See, I think some of those caves are scattered about throughout the game, too. So it's not like just, you know, it's not like just there's one in the world. There should be lots of those. There we go. All right, let's take you out. I know you can probably, there are some cool things you could do, like if you shift, or if you like sprint in a side direction, you do kind of like do this little side jog here, side dodge. Like the melee system seems pretty intricate. I'm just a certified baboon, so I don't know if I could quite figure that out. There we go, got the last egg. You got anything on you? Prayer to Haman. It's creepy, I'll give it that. Maybe I could read it again. I don't know if I want to read that thing again. Gave me the eebie-jeebies, but I do want to check that out again. What the hell? And I want to figure out how the hell to get rid of corruption. Is there anything in attributes? Hold up, let's learn recipes. Corruption? I'm not seeing nothing. Survival, combat, decoration, construct. I don't know how we get rid of corruption. I guess we'll have to find that out. That's going to be something we're going to have to figure out in the series, unless we just want to have this low everything. Info. Oh, Lord of the Darkness, of men who are not men, give us strength and suffering. If we're the, okay, speaking of strength and suffering, give me strength against this monstrosity. There we go. You know, it sucks that our freaking shield broke so easy. We need more wood to repair it, apparently. That won't be too bad, but still. Our damn shield broke, man. That sucks. Okay, here we got this lady. We'll go ahead and take her out here. I wouldn't mind. She's only a single thrall. She should respawn pretty soon. And she's a dancer, too. Okay, so if we could tame her. We can't tame her until we get to level 10. That's the thing. But if we could tame her, she could dance for us. Oh, that's right. Dancers can lower corruption. Oh. Let's keep that in mind. That's actually kind of cool positioning. Right outside the Cave of Corruption, they got a campfire with a dancer. Oh. They knew what they were doing with that. Speaking of knowing what we were doing, I mean, we're a little past halfway to level 8. Let's keep on. Whoa! Whoa! They multiplied and teleported. Jesus Christ, how bad is my connection? Probably awful. And I'm not just saying that to be like, oh, the game's better than it is. Like, no, for real, my connection has been kind of poopy for the past 30 minutes. It makes no sense whatsoever. Keep on harvesting these things, though. Yeah, now I really want to get to level 10 because... we really do... I don't want to have this corruption with us because we lost... What do I need? More stone? God damn it. We lost more than I would have liked to lose, you know? We definitely lost more than I would have liked to lose. I think the bodies are right there. Oh, there they are. Okay, I'm an idiot. I thought I lost them for a sec. Come on, my dude. There you go. Huh. Alright. Well, I guess we should keep our eyes peeled for more things like that around here. Because that place is definitely not friendly. And oh, that was a tree falling in the distance. Maybe we'll adventure a little bit more that way next time. I mean, we're gonna be low on food, not food, just low on health, but we can't do anything about that. We can, however, and I do wanna, however, drop some stuff off before we begin our next adventure and magically fall off. God damn it. But that's gonna go ahead and do it for me. Thank you guys a whole ton for watching. Again, remember, leave a comment, make sure you're subscribed for more parts, and like that video. And then part 6, I'll announce the winners of the giveaway. But the series is, we're discovering some interesting things that I like totally drew a blank on, and I kind of want to get some revenge at that camp, but I wouldn't just mind exploring everything else. So we'll see you next episode. That's going to do it for me. Thank you guys a whole ton for watching. Have yourselves a fantastic day, and I will talk to you in the next one. See ya.